Today we will discuss Bresenham's line algorithm. Bresenham's line algorithm is a highly efficient method for scan converting a line. It produces mathematically accurate results for using only integer addition, subtraction and multiplication by 2, which can be accomplished by simple arithmetic shift operation. Now the computer can perform the integer operations like addition, subtraction very rapidly. Therefore, the lines drawn are of superior quality as compared to the DDA method that we have done in the last lecture. The best approximation of the true line is described by those pixels in the raster that fall the least distance from the true line. For example, if we have taken these positions, and suppose this is 10, 11, 12, 13, this one is 10, 11, 12, 13, like this. Suppose initially the current position is this one. This is the pixel position and we have this line. Right? So if the initial position, the current position is x0, y0 is this one, 10, 11, then we have to find out the nearest neighbors of this particular position, this particular pixel, so that can be drawn. Right? So it can be either this position or this position. So the coordinates for this one will be 11, 11. It can be 11, 11 or it can be 11, 12. So we have to find out which pixel position, either this one or this one, is to be drawn to scan convert this line. Right? So illustration of Bresenham's approach. Now we will consider a scan conversion process for the lines with slope less than 1, but it should be positive. So m is a slope that is between 0 and 1. Now the starting position from x0, y0 of a given line, we step to each successive column x position and plot the pixel whose scan line y is closed to the line bar. For example, we will modify this one, or we can draw a new diagram for this. Suppose we have, this is xk, this is xk plus 1, this is xk plus 2, like this, and so on. And this is yk, yk plus 1, yk plus 2, like this. Now, initially we have the pixel at xk, yk, and this is the line. Now, suppose the current position is xk, yk. Now, we have to find out the nearest neighbor of this xk, yk pixel. Right? So it can be either this one or this one. So it can be xk plus 1, yk plus 1, or it can be xk plus 1 and yk itself. So this one is pointing to this pixel, and this location is pointing to this location. So we have to find out so this is our line, y is equal to msb. We can represent a line by using this equation. So now we assume that the determined pixel is this one. Now we have to find out the next location. Either the next location can be either this one or this one. So suppose we are taking the decision variable. On the basis of that decision variable, we will find out which line, which pixel is to be plotted next. So suppose this is a line and have a pixel here on this line, and initially it is yk, then we have yk y, and then we have yk plus 1, and this is the pixel, this is the current position, and now we have to plot a pixel that is near to this pixel, either this one or this one. So we call it as the S and we call it as T. The pixel above the line is T and the pixel below the line is S, and suppose the distance of T from the pixel position is D1, D2, and the distance of S from the original position is D1. What is D1 and D2? D1 and D2 are the vertical separations from a mathematical line path at sampling position xk plus 1. This is our xk plus 1. So that is our motive. We have to find out the nearest neighbor of the position. Now the y coordinate on the mathematical line at pixel column position xk plus 1 is calculated as y is equal to m xk plus 1 plus b. So this is our equation number 1. Now d1, that is the decision parameter, y minus yk. So d1 is y minus yk equal to, we will replace this y with the help of equation number 1, and it will be m xk plus 1 plus b minus yk. Now we will say it at equation number a. Then decision parameter 2, that is the difference between yk plus 1 and y. So d2 is yk plus 1 minus y, that is the decision parameter for pixel T. We will get yk plus 1 minus m xk plus 1 minus b. So we will call this equation as b. Now it is equivalent to, now we have to subtracting b, equation number b from a, and we will get d1 minus d2. So we will get 2m xk plus 1 minus 2yk plus 2b minus 1. Now this is our equation number 2. Now m is the slope here, so we can substitute m is equal to delta y divided by delta x to find the decision parameter dk for kth step, right? So dk is equal to 2 delta y divided by delta x, xk plus 1 minus 2yk plus 2b minus 1. So this is the decision parameter at kth step, right? So after solving this equation, we will get 2 dk is equal to 2 delta y dot xk plus 2 delta y minus 2 delta x multiplied by yk plus 2 delta x multiplied by b minus delta x. So we will call this equation as equation number 3, and we can also write this equation C as 2 delta y dot xk minus 2 delta x dot yk plus C. Now C is a constant that we have taken, and what is the value of C? Here C is equal to 2 delta y plus delta x 2b minus 1. This is the value of your c. That is a constant. Now there are two cases arises. Case 1 and 2 says, if d1 is less than d2, then the decision variable at kth step is negative. So we will plot the lowest pixel. So if d1 is less than d2, that means this distance is less than this distance. So we will plot s. Plot pixel s. Otherwise, if d2 is less than d1, in that case we will plot pixel t. So this is the decision variable at kth step. Now we have to find out the decision variable at k plus 1 step. So dk plus 1 will be 2 delta y x k plus 1 minus 2 delta x dot y k plus 1 plus c. So what we have done, we have modified the equation number 3, and we have put, because we have to find out the value of decision parameter d at k plus 1 step, so we have replaced k by k plus 1 in the equation number 3, and we have got the decision parameter d at k plus 1 position. So we will name it as equation number 4. Now we have to subtract equation 3 from 4, that is we have to subtract the value of decision parameter at k plus 1 step. We have to subtract the decision parameter at k step from the k plus 1 decision variable. So we will get, after subtracting 3 from 4, we will get dk plus 1 minus dk equal to 2 delta y xk plus 1 minus xk minus 2 delta x yk plus 1 minus yk. So but as you can see here, xk plus 1 xk plus 1 is equal to xk this plus 1. So k plus 1 value of x will be kth value plus 1. So we are incrementing the value of x by unit step. So after substituting the value, this value in this equation, we will get dk plus 1 equal to dk plus 2 delta y minus 2 delta x yk plus 1 minus yk, where the term yk plus 1 minus yk is either 0 or 1 depending on the sign of the parameter dk. Now if the chosen pixel is the top pixel, that means d2 is greater than d1. In case when chosen pixel is t and d2 is greater than d1, in that case yk plus 1 is, if d2 is greater than d1, then yk plus 1 is equal to yk plus 1, because we are incrementing the k plus 1th value of y. We are getting the k plus 1 value of y by incrementing the k value of y by 1. So after substituting this value in the equation, we will get dk plus 1 equal to dk plus 2 delta y minus delta x. So this is our equation number 5, where we are getting the value of the k plus 1 th decision variable in terms of kth decision variable. Now this is case 1, when d2 is greater than d1, that means we are plotting the pixel t. But in other case, when d1 is greater than d2, if d1 is greater than d2, in that case then our yk, k plus 1 will be equal to yk. So because in this case k plus 1 th value is this one, yk. So k plus 1 th value of y variable will be equal to the kth value of y. So after putting this value in equation number this one, then we will get dk plus 1 equal to dk plus 2 delta y. That is our equation number 6. So these are the values. Why we are saying? Because we have to, when we will solve the numerical problem, in that case we have to find out the decision variable for the next position. So we have to find out the nearest neighbor that is to be plotted from the current position. So for that we need the decision parameter for the next step, right? So that's why we will need this equation number 5 and 6 in the algorithm. Now the two line endpoints and store the left endpoint in x naught y naught. So in step one, suppose we are having this line. So suppose this is the initial point and this is the ending point. So we have to store the value of this leftmost point of this line in x naught y naught. Now in step two, we have to load x naught y naught, that is the initial x naught y naught points of the line, into the frame buffer. That is, we have to plot the first point, that is x naught y naught. Now third step is, we have to calculate the constants like delta x, delta y, 2 delta y and 2 delta y minus 2 delta x. We need these constant values in solving the problem. So we will calculate these values and then obtain the starting value for decision parameter. That means we have to calculate B naught. That is, B naught is equal to 2 delta y minus delta x, that we have already solved. This is equation number 7, right? So we have to calculate B naught. Then in step 4, at each xk along the line, starting at k is equal to 0, we have to perform the following tests. Now, when we have, suppose we have started with this, this is our x naught y naught. So we have to find out the next pixel that is to be plotted on this line. So it can be either s or it can be t, right? So we have to find out the nearest pixel that is to be plotted after the current position. So that test we have to do. That means we have to find, we have to write these conditions: whether d1 is greater than d1 or d1 is greater than d2.
And and we have to plot the pixel xk plus 1 and yk plus 1. And the decision parameter for this will be dk plus 1 equal to dk plus 2 delta y minus 2 delta x. And step number 5 is repeat step 4 delta x times. So how many times we have to repeat this test? That is delta x times. So these are the steps for drawing a line using Bresnahan's line algorithm. Now we will see an example how we can digitize a line using this algorithm. So these are the basic steps that are required. Now the example. Digitize the line with endpoints by using Bresnahan's line drawing algorithm. Now the solution. So what was the first step? We have to what are the x0 and y0? Not in this case, x0 and y0 is your 20 and 10. So that is our first step. X0, y0 is equal to 20, 10. That is the leftmost point on the line. Now we have to calculate the constant values, that is delta x is equal to, it is x2 minus x1. So x2 is this one, x1 is this one. So or we can say x0, y0. So it is 30 minus 20, that is 10. Delta y is y2 minus y1. See, initially if we take a line, x1, y1 is the leftmost point and x2, y2 is the rightmost point of the line. That is the end point. These are the two endpoints that have been given. So we are finding delta x and delta y. So y2 minus y1 means 18 minus 10, that is equal to 8. Now we have to find out the slope. So slope is m, that is delta y upon delta x, that is 8 upon 10, that is equivalent to 0.8. So that is our slope. Now as we can see, the mod of m is less than 1. So we have to find out the initial decision parameter, that is d0, and d0 is equal to 2 delta y minus delta x, that is equivalent to 2 into 8 minus 10 equal to 6. Now we have to calculate 2 delta y, that is 2 into 8, that is 16, and then we have to calculate 2 delta y minus 2 delta x, that is equal to 16 minus 20, that is minus 4. So these are the constant values that we have to calculate. Now we will go to the step 4. So first we have to plot the initial point, that is x0, y0, that is your 20 and 10. So we have plotted the first point. Now we have to determine the successive pixel positions along the path from the decision parameter d0. So how many times we will repeat the step number 4 that we will do? That is delta x times. That means delta x is 10. So we have to repeat it from k is equal to 0 to k is equal to 9. So we can make a table so that that will be easier for us. So k, we have to find out this parameter at kth position, then this is in parameter at k plus 1th position, then we have to find out x k plus 1th and y k plus 1th coordinates. So it all depends on the value of k, this is the value of kth position decision parameter. So we will start with 0. Now initially d naught is 6. When k is equal to 0, d naught is 6, that means that is greater than 0. So for that there was an equation. I will write that equation so that that will be easier for us. So if dk is less than 0, then we have to plot xk plus 1 yk, and dk plus 1 will be dk plus 2 delta I. Otherwise, when it is positive, we have to plot xk plus 1 and yk plus 1, and we have to calculate dk plus 1 as dk plus 2 delta y minus 2 delta x. So initially when dk is 6, that means that is greater than 0, that is positive. So we have to plot xk plus 1 and yk plus 1. So initially it is 20 and 10. So we will get 21 and 11 that we have to plot. Right? We have incremented the x and y coordinates of the initial position by 1. Right? So, and we have to calculate dk plus 1 according to this equation, that is dk, dk is 6, 6 plus 2 delta y minus 2 delta x. So we have got this from this equation 6. So we will get 6 minus 4, that is equal to 2. So that is our first step. We have to plot. First we have plotted 20 and 10. Now we have plotted 21, 11. Now when k is 1, in that case dk is, d1 is 2. So now it is greater than 0. It is positive. So again we have to increment the value of this x and y by 1. So we will get 22 and 12. And we have to calculate dk plus 1 with the help of this equation. And we will get 2 minus 4 is equal to minus 2. Now when k is 3, dk is minus 2, that is less than 0. So we have to increment the x coordinate by 1 and the y coordinate will remain as it is. So we will get 23 and 12. And when we calculate dk plus 1, we will get minus 2 plus 16 and we will get 14. So, sorry, there is a mistake. It is step number 2 and it is negative, so we have incremented only x coordinate, y coordinate will remain as it is. Now we will calculate, because it is less than 0, so we have to calculate with this equation, and it will be minus 2 plus 16 and we will get 40. Now at k is equal to 3, we have dk is 14, that is positive. So when the decision parameter is positive, we have to increment x and y coordinate by 1. So we will get this coordinate, and we have to calculate dk plus 1, that is 14 minus 4, that is 10. Now when k is 4, we will get we have dk as 10 that we have calculated in the last step. Now it is positive, so we have to increment x and y coordinate by 1. And we have to calculate dk. So dk is 6. Now when k is 5, in that case it is again, when k is 5, dk is 6, we will get, that is positive, so we have to increment it x and y by 1. So we will get 26, 15, and we have to calculate dk plus 1, that we will get 2. Now at step number 6, when k is 6, decision parameter is 2, so that is positive, so increment by 1, so we will get 27, 16, and we have to calculate dk plus 1, that is minus 2. Now at when k is 7, it is minus 2, that means that is negative. So we have to increment only x coordinate, that is 28, and y will remain as it is. We have to calculate dk plus 1, we will get minus 14. So at when k is 8 and k is minus 14, that is negative, so we have to increment only x coordinate and we will get 29, 16. So we will get minus 14 plus 16. That is 2. Now it is positive, so we have to increment 30, 70, we have plotted 21, 11, 22, 12, 23, 12, 24, 13, 25, 14, 26, sorry, because this is positive, so we have to increment it by 1, 26, 15, then 27, 16, 28, 16, 29, 17. So the last quadrant is 30 minus 18. See, at this one, it is plus 14. Minus 2 plus 16, that is 40. So because this is positive, so so it is minus 2, 16, 40, then 40. When we are calculating 40 minus 4, we are getting 10. So it is positive, so we will plot 29, 17. And when again it is plus 16, it is 2. So it is positive, so we are plotting 30, 18, and there is no need to calculate the k plus 1 step, as we have to repeat this step delta x time, that is 10 times. So we have started from k is equal to 0 to k is equal to 9. So this is the example of your Bresenham's line algorithm. Bresenham's line algorithm is more efficient as compared to TDA because only addition and subtraction arithmetic operations have been performed to find out the pixels that have to be plotted or how to scan convert that line. Now next topic is circle generating algorithm. Circle generating algorithms. See, when we are saying the circle, since circle is a frequently used component in pictures and graphs, a single procedure can be provided to display either circular or elliptical curves. Now the properties of a circle. When we are saying properties of circle, a circle can be defined as a set of points that are all at a given distance r from the center position. So
draw a diagram.
center point x, c, y, c. So it can be defined by this, and this is the distance r. So we can say this is your circle. This is the way of defining a circle. A circle is having a radius and the center point. Now this distance relationship is expressed by the Pythagoras theorem in Cartesian coordinates as x minus xc whole square plus y minus yc whole square is equal to r square. That is our equation number 1. So equation number 1 could be used to calculate the position of points on a circumference by stepping along the x-axis in unit steps from xc minus r to xc plus r, and calculating the corresponding value of y. How to calculate the value of y? That is y is equal to yc plus minus under the root r square minus xc minus x whole square. So this is our equation number 2. But this is not the best method for generating the circle. As a lot of computation is required, then we will calculate all the values of y corresponding to x. So that is very that requires a lot of computation. So the spacing between plotted point pixels is not uniform. Therefore, circle equation is in parametric polar form. Now, circle equation in parametric polar form is used where r and theta are the polar coordinates, and we will have x is equal to xc plus r cos theta, and y is equal to yc plus r sin theta. So where r and theta are the polar coordinates. So this is our equation number 3 and this is our equation number 4. For more continuous boundary on a raster display, we can set the step size at 1 by r. So computation can be reduced by considering the symmetry of circles, as shape of the circle is similar in each quadrant. Any circle generating algorithm can take the advantage of circle symmetry to plot 8 points for each value that the algorithm calculates. Now, circle has 8-way symmetry. So, how we will calculate that? When we are saying 8-way symmetry, so we can calculate the points in one octet, and we can plot the reflections of those points in other 7 octets. So, we can see here. So suppose we have divided this into 8 equal parts. So suppose a point xy is there, and in the second one we will get the reflection of this minus xy. Here we will get y minus x. Then here we will get minus y minus x. Here we will get minus x minus y. Here we will get x minus y. This point will be minus y x, and this point will be y x. So this is a 8-way symmetry. So if we are finding the pixels in this octant, so we can plot the corresponding reflections in the other 7 octants. So that is the 8-way symmetry of the circle, and we can use this property of the circle for calculating the pixel positions on the circle. So how to define a circle? There are two methods for defining a circle. Method 1 is we can define a circle with second order polynomial equation. That is y square is equal to r square minus x square, where r is the radius. So that is the first method. In each x coordinate in the sector 90 degree to 45 degree can be found by stepping x from 0 to r divided by root 2 to y, and y by r square minus x square under the root. So that is the first method. So we can draw a diagram for this also. Suppose this is the circle. Circle is at origin. Center point is at origin. So this is radius r. Now this is the x position. This is the y position. Now this coordinate will, the coordinates of this pixel will be x and r square minus x square. So this is for method 1. Now method 2 is use of trigonometric function. That is, where we will take x is equal to r cos theta and y is equal to r sin theta. So how to represent this diagrammatically? This is for method 1 and this is for method 2. Suppose the circle is at the origin. So this is angle theta. This is the radius. So this distance will be r cos theta, and this distance will be r sin theta. So r, this coordinate, suppose this pixel p is having the coordinates r cos theta and r sin theta. So these are the coordinates in case of method 2. Now by the trigonometric function method, the theta is stepped from theta to pi by 4, and each value of x and y is calculated.